If your 2022 goals did not include learning all the Ghanaian fufu eating techniques, then you today, by watching this video, you get the chance to try out my 5 techniques to score goals with pounded fufu and soup. Playing soccer on the field is not the only way to score goals. Imagine scooping your own fufu bowl in your hand, and sweeping it past delicious soup, straight into your open mouth to score. Pounded fufu eaten by hand, score goals in your mouth, more than during a football match. That fufu island is soon dismantled, into smaller scoring goals. Fufu goals are on, soccer goals are also on. Ghanaians love their pounded fufu on any day of the week because it is a special dish. Because of this, you must learn to eat it well whether you're a local or in the diaspora. In today's video, I want to introduce to you the techniques in eating our favorite Ghanaian dish, fufu and soup. There is more to the etiquette of fufu and palm nut soup eating than you might know. To most Ghanaians, table etiquette at mealtime is important. Because fufu is pounded into a smooth, soft texture before eaten together with soup, with the hand, it can be more tricky than your everyday finger food. Just for your information, Ghana fufu is not the same as finger food. There's more to eating fufu by hand. There are indeed different ways Ghanaians like to eat their fufu with their clean hands. Some of these techniques have evolved with time and circumstances. Please subscribe now, comment and share, so that I can dip into this ball of pounded fufu and soup now. And show you how goals are scored with balls of fufu and soup. With today's video, I still stand by the Ghana pounded fufu against the powdered fufu. This is because our pounded fufu is still the number one choice in the Ghanaian local chop bars. Pounding fufu by hand involves the use of a handheld pestle, used to pound and mix steamed yam, cassava, or plantain inside a wooden mortar or bowl. When steamed tubers or plantain are pounded and mixed repeatedly, the starch and sugars turn the texture into smooth, soft, and almost stretchy texture. I have seen fufu making machines being promoted. They operate like the traditional corn mill motor operated machines. I won't recommend them because these reasons. Firstly, they contribute to polluting our environment. Pounding fufu by hand is one less source or carbon emission into the atmosphere, to look at it from an environmentally safe point of view. Secondly, employing the use of fufu making machines eliminates the need to hire manual labor. Thirdly, they don't taste as good as when pounded and turned by human hand, according to my personal research on the psychology behind preferences for pounded fufu over powdered forms. So, we need to continue pounding for extra income for the unemployed and to stay fit. You might want to watch my previous video on 10 reasons to eat traditional pounded fufu. Pounding Ghana fufu by hand makes cassava and plantain fufu super soft and yummy. You can ask some of the local Ghanaian chop bar owners. Even local restaurants know what this labor of love means to their customers. By the way, chop bar is a colloquial term for a low-cost restaurant. At an affordable price for the average Ghanaian, these foods are still cooked with love. Last time, I talked about both pounded and powdered fufu types. Powdered fufu is easy for one person to prepare. It also cooks faster and can taste delicious fufu. With one hand, you can mix and turn the powdered cassava, yam or plantain mix over heat. And the other hand, firmly hold down the pot over heat to cook. Some Ghanaians like their fufu soft, smooth and stretchy. Others prefer firm fufu balls. Well-prepared fufu goes down more smoothly. It also tastes better. It's stretchy and soft, and that is the right texture. What do most Ghanaians have as accompaniment with pounded fufu? Popular accompaniment for fufu is freshly cooked soup. Types of soups that go best with fufu are palm nut soup, peanut soup, or light soup. Fresh fish and palm nut soup taste superb. My father's favorite was river fish. They are usually sold dried in the local market. With soups, I like it when freshly diced vegetables are added. When cooked, both meat or fish and vegetables will take turns, appearing on the surface of the soup as it simmers. Snails and mushrooms are a delicacy in Ghana, although they can be pricey. Fresh okra and eggplant, when added, also adds fresh flavor, taste and nutrients to soup or broth. Dried fish, such as herrings, are often perceived as the poor man's substitute for meat. But dried or smoked fish is healthy for you. It is not fatty but has this aroma smell when cooked in soup. If you eat fufu and soup with your hands, the aroma lingers on, even after washing your hands. What goes inside any type of soup, be it palm nut or peanut, is based on personal preference. So, we have the meat lovers, the fish fans and vegetarian faithfuls. The fresh meat lovers have either beef, goat meat or even game meat. Antelope, or a Nkrantie. Meat is popular in some specialty food joints, and I hear that they are very dear. For low-income earners, dried or smoked fish is pocket-friendly. Now that I have got your mouth watering, let's dive straight into the fufu eating styles. And here is my number 5. If you are not an African or Ghanaian, then you're pardoned for eating fufu with a spoon. But this has to change now. Get to know some Ghanaians who can show you the proper ways to eat hand-pounded fufu. We eat fufu and soup with our clean hands. I promise you it tastes so much better eating fufu and palm nut soup with your hands. So no more fufu spoons. Number 4. The middle and index fingers cut style. Bring these two fingers together like so. There are two different ways to approach the fufu cut technique. Either dive into the starchy island head on, that is dipping both fingertips in first. Or, approach by cutting technique with the side of the middle finger. Whilst those two fingers are still held tight together, cut through the soft mass, and scoop some soup along the way. How do you manage this move? Scoop fufu and soup by simply flipping your two fingers upward to face up, as you draw your mouth closer to the food. Easy does it. Number 3. The three fingers and rule. Well explained. Just close up the index, middle and fourth fingers together. Slightly cup the tightly held fingers to scoop. Ghanaian men usually like this technique. Especially when they are hungry, and don't want to waste time around a bowl of fufu and nkrantie or peanut soup. The three-finger technique ensures that the biggest ball is scooped to collect as much soup as possible, before a quick sweep is made into a widely open mouth. Remember, it's considered rude, and actually childish, to have soup smeared all over your mouth whilst eating. You also don't want to spoil your plain clothing whilst eating fufu and soup. So, please pay attention, and handle this step with care. Not subscribed yet, show me some love by doing so, and also turn the notifications button on to get alert when I post my next video. Let's now move to number 2. And this is the rule of thumb. Follow step 3 using your index, middle and fourth finger. But only, this time, including your thumb. The purpose of the right thumb in fufu eating competition, for instance, is to make a grip and a dip, to scoop more soup. More means, bigger mouthfuls and faster sweeps towards the mouth. The rule of thumb as a fufu eating technique is the most common way to enjoy fufu and soup with your hands. Making a dip in the middle of the fufu also makes room for meat or vegetables to go all at once. Fingers and thumb in fufu eating gives a better grip on the food with your hands. Some people accidentally drop the smooth piece of fufu as they try to find their mouth. When you drop fufu into soup, it can make a splash and stain your clothing. Brave up and eat with care. For an adult, this is unacceptable. So by all means, use your hands together with the extra support of your thumb. So what is the number 1 fufu eating technique? I reserve this for the number 1 fufu eating technique, because it's an added dimension to enjoy our Ghana fufu and soup. Let me show you in colored pictures how this is done. Yes. Instead of eating fufu and soup using your own hands, let someone else show you some fufu love. Since the preparation and consumption of pounded fufu with soup is considered a social activity, it makes sense to allow your loved one to score fufu goals for you. Hand feeding fufu to a lady or man is an African gesture of love. It's sweet to be fed. Yes, my baby. But this is a much harder technique to do. Your hand's maneuver is different and can be tricky, especially with soup. The rule of thumb technique works very well here. Also, make sure that this person knows what they're doing, or else they can make a mess of your clothing. In fact, you too can use my number one fufu eating technique to either test your love chemistry, or to simply shake up a dull relationship. Fufu stands for fufu. Fufu is filling, and is super traditional when pounded by hand. Moreover, Ghanaian fufu and soup tastes much better when eaten with the fingers. Try out my fufu eating styles and share your videos or photos with me. Thanks for watching this video. My name is Akos, I love to be Ghanaian and I love my traditional colors, designs, tastes and music. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel, also like and comment on this video, share with others to increase my reach. Until next time, it's fufu all the way. Goodbye from Akos, the African Diaspora Lens.